everyone, welcome to the course Electronic Circuits and Analysis 1. We are in the module Linear Wave Shaping Circuits. We have already covered RC low pass filter circuit. Now we are interested in studying about RC high pass filter circuit. And in turn, we have also looked at what is the response of RC high pass filter circuit when the input is a sinusoidal input. So now we are interested in finding the step response of the RC high pass filter circuit. Okay, so let's begin. So look at now. So what is the output voltage equation that is known to you? The output voltage equation is V naught of t is equal to Vf minus Vi into e power minus of t minus ti by tau. So this is what is the equation. We are very much familiar with this. Okay, right. So what is all that I have to do now is, anyway, for t less than 0, my input is 0. Okay, so when my input is 0, my output is 0. But for t greater than or equal to 0, that is over the interval 0 to infinity, okay, where my input is capital V, we are interested in what is my output is. Okay, so you all need to find out over the interval 0 to infinity, what is your Vf, what is your Vi, what is your Ti, and what is your tau. Of course, tau is nothing but your RC, which is the time constant. Okay. So over the interval 0 to infinity, what is my Vf is? My Vf is given by, okay, over the interval 0 to infinity, my Vf is given by, as Vf is nothing but your output voltage, okay, which is nothing but your across your resistor R, at t is equal to infinity. But you know that at t is equal to infinity, the capacitor is completely going to be charged, because the minimum of 5 seconds is sufficient for your capacitor to completely charge. So my entire input voltage, which is nothing but the capital V, is going to appear across the capacitor. So that when I observe my output voltage across the resistor, or at t is equal to infinity, what is my output is going to be? 0, because my entire input is going to appear across the capacitor, because I am looking my output at t is equal to infinity. Okay. So and what is my Ti is given as? Ti is nothing but the time at which you are applying the input. At what time you are applying the input, at t is equal to 0. So my Ti is going to be 0. Right? What is my Vi is going to be? My Vi is going to be my output voltage at t is equal to Ti. So that means at t is equal to 0 seconds, so what is my output is going to be? At t is equal to 0 seconds, you change your input suddenly from 0 volts to capital V volts. Can your voltage across the capacitor can change suddenly because of the changes in the input signal? No. Your capacitor voltage cannot change instantaneously. So my Vi is going to be capital V because my capacitor cannot change its voltage instantaneously. Okay. And my tau time constant is given as RC. Okay. With all these values, when I substitute in my equation, Vf minus Vi into e power minus of t minus ti by tau, I will be getting an equation. Okay. What is the equation I am getting? I will be getting an equation which is nothing but 0 minus 0 minus capital V into e power minus of t by tau. Okay. It is equal to capital V into e power minus t by tau. Okay. Right, so my output voltage is given as capital V into e power minus t by tau. This is what is called as standard discharging equation. Standard discharging equation. Okay, so this equation is what is called as a standard discharging equation. Okay, sometimes it is called as exponentially decaying function. Okay, so when we have applied the step input signal to your RC high pass filter circuit, the equation that we have obtained is the standard discharging equation. Okay, and the how does that equation is going to look like? Capital V into e power minus of t by tau, right? Okay. So the response of RC high pass filter circuit when the step input is applied is what is represented here. Okay, so it is going to look like capital V into e power minus of t by tau. Your output is primarily a function of a time variable t. Okay, so for different values of t, okay, when you plug in different values of t, you will be getting your output response. For example, when you substitute t is equal to 0, what is your output is going to be? Your output is same as your capital V. Okay, my output is same as your capital V. E power minus 0 is 1, so 1 into V is V. Similarly, suppose if you have substituted your t is equal to tau. Okay, so what is that your output is going to be at t is equal to tau? V into e power minus 1. What is V into e power minus 1 in particular? It is 0.367. So that means roughly the time at which your t is equal to tau, your output is given by 36.7% of your maximum value. What is the maximum value? Capital V. Okay. So when I plot different values of t, I will be able to. Okay. So this is how it is going to look like. Right. For example, let us say that this is tau. And maybe roughly this is at 4 tau. Okay, all right. So this is what it is going to look like. So at t is equal to tau, okay, at t is equal to tau, its value is going to be 0.367 times capital V. Okay, 0.367 times capital V. So that means now we can define a time constant, okay, which is applicable only to the RC high pass filter circuit. That is, time constant is the time at which the response is going to be 36.7% of the maximum value. Earlier in the case of RC low pass filter circuit, we defined the time constant as the time that is required for your output to reach 63.2% of the maximum value. Now, it is something different that you could define your time constant in the case of RC high pass filter, that is time required for reaching 36.7% of its final value. Okay, so this is applicable to your RC high pass filter circuit, whereas the time constant that we have learned earlier is applicable only to the RC low pass filter circuit. Okay, so this is representing a standard discharging equation, and earlier with respect to your RC low pass filter circuit, it is representing a standard charging equation. T is equal to 5 tau. Okay, you all know that the voltage across the capacitor is going to have the entire input voltage that is applied here. So naturally, the voltage across the R at T is equal to 5 tau is going to be 0. So that is why it is shown here that as I am moving closer to my t is greater than 5 tau, my output is likely to reach almost 0. Okay, but only at t is equal to infinity, you could have your output to be 0. That is why I have not drawn this line and this line as touching. Okay, so this line is going to touch 0 axis only at t is equal to infinity. But at 5 tau, it is almost very close to 0. Because at 5 tau, your capacitor is going to acquire almost the entire voltage that is applied at the input. Okay, so the step response of RC high pass filter circuit is nothing but your standard discharging equation, and it is mathematically represented as capital V into e power minus of t by tau. Okay, right. Okay, so now our interest is to find the response of RC high pass filter circuit when the input is a pulse input. Okay, so this is how the pulse is going to look like. Right, so only over the interval 0 to tp, your input is said to be capital V, whereas it is 0 otherwise. Right, so that is the pulse duration, okay, which is denoted by TP, only for that duration your input is going to be defined as capital B. For all other time, it is going to be 0. Okay, this is what is a pulse input, how does it is going to look like. Okay, and moreover, 0 minus means just before 0. Just before 0 means at t is equal to 0, you are applying your input from 0 to capital B, and you are making your input to remain as capital B until TP. And at TP, after TP, you are making your input again from V to 0. This is what you are doing. Okay, this is what is you are doing, right? So at t is equal to 0 minus, just before 0, your input is 0. Just after 0, your input is no more 0, but it is capital V. Okay. So at 0 plus, your input is capital V. Similarly, TP minus means just before TP, and TP plus means just after TP. Just before TP, your input is capital V. Just after TP, your input is 0. Okay. So this much understanding is enough for finding the response of this circuit when this kind of input is applied. Okay. So normally your output varies depending upon your time constant. So we will be considering two cases. One is case number one, okay, where your RC is much greater than TP. Okay. Your RC is much greater than TP. Right. So in the case your RC is much greater than TP, we will be considering two intervals. One is 0 to TP, okay, and there is TP to infinity. Okay, one is 0 to TP, and the another interval we are going to consider is TP to infinity. So over 0 to TP, what do I mean is it is something like 0 plus. Okay, 0 plus means where your input is capital V, right? And t less than TP means you are considering only up to TP minus. TP minus means your input is capital V only. So that means what? For this entire duration, your input is found to be a step input. For a step input, you know already how does the output that is taken across this R is going to look like. How does it is going to look like? It is going to look like capital V into e power minus of t by tau. Okay, so my output voltage, okay, my output voltage is going to look like, okay, capital V into e power minus of t by tau. Okay, standard discharging equation. Alright, because only over the interval it is just similar to your step input. So for step input, we have already found out what is the response, and this is how it is going to look like. Okay. And at t is equal to TP, okay, at t is equal to TP, at t is equal to TP, let my V naught of t is equal to capital V1. So that what is capital V1 is given by? Capital V1 is given by capital V into e power, just replace t with TP. So e power minus of TP by tau. Okay. So exactly at t is equal to TP, my V1 is given as V into e power minus TP by tau. Okay, is this fine? Okay. So my voltage across the capacitor at t is equal to TP, okay, my voltage across the capacitor at t is equal to TP is nothing but Vi of t minus voltage across the resistor, which is nothing but my output voltage. Okay. What is my output voltage at t is equal to TP? My output voltage I have denoted at t is equal to TP with V1, so that my voltage across the capacitor is given by input voltage minus output voltage. And what is my input voltage at t is equal to TP? TP is nothing but in this particular interval, it is TP minus, at TP minus my input voltage is capital V. So my input voltage minus output voltage is what is my voltage across the capacitor. That is why I have written input voltage is capital V minus output voltage is denoted by V1 at t is equal to TP. Okay. So my Vc of TP, which is nothing but Vc of TP minus, because of this interval, it is nothing but TP minus. Okay. So my Vc of TP is found to be V minus V1. Okay. Right. Okay. So now we are in the interval TP to infinity. Okay. So how do I find my output over the interval TP to infinity? I have an equation V naught of t is equal to Vf minus Vi into e power minus of t minus Ti by tau. Okay. So over this interval, what is my output is given by, or like my Vf is given by, my Vf is equal to, okay. In this interval, it is something like Tp plus, because Tp is less than T, is in other words, T is greater than Tp. So T is greater than Tp means Tp plus. At Tp plus my input is 0. When my input is 0, when I observe my output at t is equal to infinity, what is my output is going to be 0. So my output, which is nothing but Vf, is going to be 0. And my Ti is going to be Tp. Because over this interval, what is the initial time at which I am applying the input? Tp. So my Ti is Tp. At Ti is equal to Tp, what is my output is going to be? At Ti is equal to Tp, Tp is in other words Tp plus. At Tp plus, what is my input is 0. When my input is 0, okay, when my input is 0, okay, what is my output is given by? My output is given by minus Vc, okay. My output is given by, which is nothing but Vi. Vi is nothing but my output at t is equal to Tp, is nothing but given by minus Vc. Yes or no? What is Vc? My Vc either at Tp minus or at Tp plus, both are same. What is my voltage across the capacitor? We taught earlier we taught that it is given by voltage across the capacitor is given by input voltage minus output voltage. So my input voltage is V minus my output voltage is V1. Okay, so now it is nothing but minus Vc, which is nothing but minus of V minus V1. So though we are considering a time at Tp plus, my voltage across the capacitor at Tp minus or Tp plus, both are same, because my capacitor voltage cannot change instantaneously. And what is my voltage across the capacitor is V minus V1. And now at Tp plus, my output voltage is nothing but minus Vc, because my input is 0. So when I apply the KVL, this plus this is equal to 0. So this output voltage is nothing but minus Vc. Okay. So this is what is my output voltage. Okay. So when I substitute this Vf, Ti, Vi along with tau is equal to Rc, I will be getting it as Vf is 0 minus Vf is 0 minus the output voltage at t is equal to Tp, okay, over this interval it is Tp plus, it is denoted with V2. So that what is my V2 is likely to be V1 minus capital V. V2 is nothing but your minus Vc, Vc is nothing but your V minus V1, so that minus Vc is nothing but V1 minus V. So that I am representing with V2, so that I can write my output as V2. Okay. So e power minus of t minus Tp by tau. So that my output is given by V2 in t power minus of t minus Tp by tau. Okay. So over the interval Tp to infinity, my output is given by same as the standard discharging equation, but this time the maximum value is given by V2 and the initial time at which it is starting is given by Tp. Okay. Right. Fine. Okay, for t less than 0, what is my output is going to be 0. Okay, for t less than 0, my input is 0, so my output is also 0. For t is equal to 0 plus, what is my input is capital V. So what is my output is, where I am looking at my output across the resistor. Okay, what is voltage across the capacitor? When I suddenly look at my t is equal to 0 plus, as my voltage across the capacitor cannot change instantaneously, my voltage across the resistor immediately at 0 plus is capital V only. At 0 plus, my input is capital V, my output is also capital V. Okay. And over the interval 0 to Tp, okay, my input output is going to be a standard discharging equation. It is looking like V into e power minus T by tau. Okay. V into e power minus T by tau over the interval 0 to Tp. And in particular at Tp, okay, it is denoted by V1, where V1 is given by V into e power minus Tp by tau. Okay, just replace T with Tp, which is nothing but your V1. That is your output at Tp minus. At Tp plus, what is your output is? Okay, your output is nothing but V2, where V2 is given by V1 minus capital V. Why V1 minus capital V? At Tp plus, your input has changed from capital V to 0. That means you have added minus V to your input. So you add minus V to your output also. That is why I have added minus V to my output, which is denoted by V1, so which is denoted by V2 here. Okay, and from TP to infinity, what is my output is being denoted by? Okay, it is denoted by V2 into e power minus of T minus TP by tau. Yes or no? This time my maximum value is V2. That means from here onwards it again starts discharging, move towards the zero. Okay, your input suddenly changed from V to zero, your output also tries to move towards the zero. Okay, this is the discharging equation. But the initial time is TP. Here the initial time is zero. Okay, right? So this is how the response of the RC high pass filter circuit, when the pulse input is applied, when the case is RC is much greater than capital small TP. Okay, right? Fine.
There are two important observations that we can point out. One is, when the input has changed from V to 0 at T is equal to TP plus, the output has changed from V1 to V2. Okay. So, in changing your input from V to 0, what we have done? We have added minus V to your input in changing your input from plus V to 0. The same thing can happen even at your output also. That is, to your output V1, we have added minus V. Okay. So, whenever there is a sudden change in your input, the corresponding change you can observe even in your output. Right? That is the first observation. Second observation is, when the input is remaining constant, your output is tending to move towards zero. When the input is remaining constant, your output is tending to move towards zero. Over the interval 0 to TP, your input is remaining constant, that is at V, during which your output is tending to move towards zero. Over the interval TP to infinity, your input is remaining constant, that is zero, then your output is tending to move towards zero. Okay, so second important observation, okay, which we can identify from this response of RC high pass filter circuit from the pulse input. Okay, right. Now we are in case 2, RC is much less than TP. Okay, so the waveform, output waveform corresponding to the input for this particular case is being drawn here. Okay, so what is the observation is, RC is much less. For a short time constant, you know that voltage across the capacitor is being charging very quickly and the entire input voltage is going to appear across the capacitor. Okay, so that means your voltage across the resistor is moving to move towards zero very quickly. So that is why you could see that, okay, there is a sharp change in your output in moving towards the zero, right? And thereafter it remains constant or remaining as zero, and suddenly at T is equal to TP plus, you changed your input from V to zero. What you might have added in changing your input from V to zero minus V, you might have added. Whenever there is a sudden change in your input, you could observe a corresponding change in the output also. So that means your output now at T is equal to TP, it is nothing but V1. Okay. To the V1, what is that I need to add now is minus V, because V minus V is what is being zero. You have made it at TP plus, so that you add to V1 minus V, so that it is going to become, okay, it is going to become minus V. Okay, why? Because V1 is zero. Okay, V1 is zero at T is equal to TP, V1 is zero. So when we add minus V to V1, that is zero, it is going to be minus V. And from then onwards, after TP plus, okay, your input is going to be zero. So your output tries to move towards the zero. Okay, so that is why your output is trying to move towards the zero. But because RC is much less, it is reaching very quickly in reaching towards zero. Okay, so this is how the output response is going to look like corresponding to the case RC is much less than TP. Very, very important. Okay, very, very important. Right. So just like earlier case, we will be considering two intervals. One is 0 to TP. Over the interval 0 to TP, what is my output voltage is given by? My output voltage is given by capital V into e power minus T by tau. Okay. At TP, okay, my output voltage at TP, right, it is nothing but represented as V1. It is given by V into e power minus Tp by tau. Okay, V into e power minus Tp by tau. Okay, that Tp, it is V1. Of course, in this case, it is 0 because Rc is much less than Tp. Right? Then what is my, let me say that this time interval be T1 and let this time interval be T2. So that what is my output at T1? It is 0. When my output at T1 is 0, what is my voltage across the capacitor at the same time T1? Capital V. Because my input should be equal to voltage across the capacitor and voltage across the resistor. If voltage across the resistor is 0, then my entire input voltage has to appear across the capacitor. Okay. So at T1, okay, at T is equal to T1 or Tp, okay, at T is equal to T1 or Tp, right? My output is going to be, okay, my output is going to be 0, okay? Even at Tp or T1, my output is going to be 0. Then my voltage across the capacitor is nothing but minus V, okay? Because my input is going to be capital V, my output is going to be 0, my voltage across the capacitor is going to be minus V, okay? Right. Over the interval Tp to infinity, what is that equation I will be having? Over the interval Tp to infinity, okay? Over the interval Tp to infinity, output voltage is going to look like, okay, Tp to infinity, what is my initial voltage? Initial voltage is minus V, okay, and how does my output is going to follow? A discharging equation, so e power minus T minus Tp by tau, okay. So without any calculations, directly I am able to write. Why? Because from Tp to infinity, my initial voltage is minus V and it is likely to discharge to move towards 0. That is why it is of the form V into e power minus of T minus Tp by 2. Because the initial time is Tp, T minus Tp. Because the initial voltage is minus V, it is minus V into e power minus of T minus Tp by tau. Okay. So this is the equation which you could get it over the interval Tp to infinity. Right? Right. In particular at T is equal to T2, okay, in particular at T is equal to T2, okay, what is my output is going to be? My output is 0, okay, my output is 0, right? My voltage across the capacitor is also 0. Why? Because in this case my input is 0, so that my output is also going to be 0. Not only output across the resistor, but also across the capacitor is also going to be 0 because there is no input signal. Okay, so is this okay? So this is a very very important case. Rc is much less than Tp for a reason that you are able to generate a positive spike. This particular portion is what is called as positive spike. This particular portion is what is called as positive spike at the beginning of the pulse. Okay, at the end of the pulse, this is the pulse duration. At the beginning of the pulse there is a positive spike. At the end of the pulse, there is a negative spike. Okay. So, positive spike of amplitude V, negative spike of amplitude minus V. Okay. So, this way of generating the positive spike and a negative spike using the RC high pass filter circuit is what is called as peaking. Okay. Is what is called as peaking. Okay. So, very, very important. Right. So this circuit is normally going to generate positive spike and negative spike when the time constant is very very short, right? Okay, I have considered two cases. One is RC is much greater than Tp pulse duration, and second case is RC is much less than Tp. Okay, so we have drawn the output waveforms and we have understood what are the observations that we can make out of it, and overall we have completed the response of RC high pass filter circuit to the pulse input. Okay, so thank you for watching. Hope you all have understood this particular topic. See you next time.